I am Lillian Bader. I died in 2015 when I was 97. Loreen has agreed to tell my story. In 1918, when Lillian was born, World War I had just ended. But the tensions in Liverpool were not over. When she was just 1 year old, there were riots in Liverpool. The 1919 riots happened because there were too many people looking for jobs after the war. In places like Liverpool, which had a settled black community, because Liverpool had been a slave port, it was very disappointing when people began blaming black workers for taking jobs. The whole situation was made worse because there was a lack of decent housing. As well as being blamed, black people were struggling to survive. Many wanted to be sent back to their homelands. You can see that tensions were a massive cause of concern by looking at these original documents. Things took a turn for the worse when a black man who had a good job on one of Liverpool's ships was dragged from a car, robbed and beaten, as was a black soldier who held 3 medals for war service. You can see that back then, black people were called coloured. At the time, Americans and the British thought coloured was a polite term for anyone who wasn't white, including people like Lillian, who had 1 black parent and 1 white parent. Today, we don't use coloured. After all, we all have a beautiful colour, don't we? Just look at these beautiful people. This is my cousin Lilia. She's the same age as me and very, very clever. This is her sister Lola. She's my cousin too and a bit of a drama queen. Here they are together. My uncle Steve is married to my mum's sister. They've been together for over 40 years and got married 30 years ago. This is me with my friends, Seher, Naya and Aaliyah, who came over for a cupcake playdate. Lillian, like my cousins, Lilia and Lola, was of mixed parentage. Her father was from Barbados and fought for the British in World War I, and her mother was British-Irish. But people weren't so open and inclusive back then. Lillian became an orphan at 9 and lived in a convent with nuns until she was 20, because it was so difficult for her to get a job because of her colour. Eventually, when war broke out, she got a job in the NAFI, which stands for Navy, Army and Air Force Institutes. She really enjoyed her job, but it just didn't work out. Lillian lost her job when someone discovered her father was black. Her supervisor really liked Lillian, and it took weeks to tell her that she had to leave. See, even back then, there were really decent people who didn't care about colour.
Oh dear, I've lost my job. I'm bitterly disappointed. Well, it's back to domestic service for me. I have no choice. It's so hard for a coloured woman like me to get a job.
Offensive on land, on the sea, and in the air. Every man who can fight is needed for fighting, and it is up to the women of Britain non-combatant duties. All three of the women's services are now open to volunteers. Whether you are married or single, if you are between the ages of 17 and a half and 45, there is a job waiting for you, a job that must be filled. Whatever job you are doing now, if it is not of the most vital necessity, you can be released. You are needed in the ATS, in the RENS, in the WAF. You are vital to the offensive.
After hearing that report, she joined the WAAF, which stands for Women's Auxiliary Air Force. Even though her brother, a sailor, had died at sea around the same time. This was in 1941.
I'm the only coloured in my branch of the WAAF, but today someone told me that I look nice in my uniform. This has really cheered me up.
Lillian trained as an instrument repairer, which was a really important role.
In just 9 months, I've been promoted to the rank of leading aircraft woman. I'm so proud.
Lillian eventually achieved the rank of acting corporal. Lillian met and married a British black man named Ramsay Bader in 1943. He was a soldier. She left the army in 1944 when she was pregnant. At the time, her husband was fighting for the British and involved in the D-Day landings. She was so worried for him and prayed to God that he would spare him. And God answered her prayers. They had two sons, one of whom became a pilot and the RAF. Later in life, Lillian Bader went to university and became a teacher. I was inspired to research Lillian Bader after a visit to Blackheath School's history department, where her picture was up on the door. I'm sure you'll agree that Lillian Bader was a formidable woman who didn't let colour get in the way of her ambition. Through this journey, I have learnt that Britain has many heroes, black, white and brown, and many are unsung. Today I salute Lillian Bader and others like her who played a crucial role in ending Hitler's dominance of Europe.